A very good morning from Team Wordaholics. I hope you'll all agree that English language is very, very critical for success in today's date. And continuing in that particular spirit, I'll be discussing five quick words with you which you must absolutely know the Wordaholics way. We at Wordaholics have been helping students across India for the last 5 years, sounding sophisticated in their work life, in their social settings, and score more in the competition exams like CAT, SAT, GRE, GMAT, SSC, Banking, UPSC. So the words that we're going to discuss today are palpable, panache, pandemonium, panegyric, and paparazzi. So starting with the first word palpable means something that is visible, something that is noticeable, is appreciable, is self-evident, something you can see visually clearly. Hindi would be suspasht, absolutely clear, ekdam clear hai, that is suspasht. Antonym is intangible. Something which is not clear, something which is not visible, is something that is intangible. Pronunciation is palpable. So what is the mnemonic way of learning this particular way, the Wordaholics way of learning this particular word, palpable? Look at the mnemonic, look at the visual that we have provided in the left hand side. The visual shows that the tree has ripe fruits in it. The pulp of the particular fruits has become very big, the size of the fruit has become big, and because of that the fruit tree is visible from a very far distance, and that is why it is noticeable. It has become noticeable because of the pulp that is contained in the fruit. So what is the mnemonic? The amount of pulp enables a person to find out, notice whether the fruit is ripe for consumption. It's visible. So what are the various usages? Fear is palpable, excitement was palpable, was noticeable. Sentence 1, with Game of Thrones about to premiere in a couple of days, the excitement is palpable. Diehard fans await with bated breath. Sentence 2, the unspoken love between Baba and Manita is palpable. We are talking about Sanju Baba over here. Truly an inspiration for couples on how love continues years after marriage. Our students keeps on asking us whether we have the entire set of 1200 words that we discussed through this particular method. The link for that particular 1200 words, the entire set of 1200 words, is available in the description of this particular video. We'll be moving to the next word. The rest of the usages, you can pause the video and practice yourself. Moving on to the next word. The next word is panache. Panache means confidence, self-assurance, flair, charisma, swagger. When you have that swagger, when you move with a swag, when you have that charisma, everybody looks at you and feels that you are confident. That is confidence, panache for you. Hindi would be thaat baat rutba. Antonym is clumsiness. When you are confident, when you are self-assured, you walk with a certain kind of swag, we walk with a certain kind of charisma, with a style. But if you do not have that swag, if you do not have that confidence, you are clumsy. So that is the antonym. Pronunciation is panache, panache. So what is a Wordaholic's way of remembering this particular word, panache? Look at the word. It looks like it consists of two different words, pan and acche. Now, you know that people consume pan masala and cigarette, and they do it with a swag. The way people smoke a cigarette, you will find that they are actually showing their particular style, that's a style in which they smoke that. People who have a panache can have their pan masala and do it that in style. So that is how you'll remember this particular word, panache, for a longer time. It is the confidence, the charisma, when people show they have the pan masala or cigarette, to look cool or smart in front of others' eyes. So what are the various usages? The first one is panache and poise. Execute with panache. Sentence 1, Virat Kohli and AB de Villiers batted with panache and their flair and aplomb to play a match-winning hand. Sentence 2, if there is someone who has represented the funny bone of the middle class with pride and panache, it's Kapil Sharma. The rest of the words you can, the rest of the sentences you can read on your own by pausing the video. We'll be not spending too much time on the usages because it consumes a lot of time on the part of students. The next word that we're going to discuss today is pandemonium. That is turbulence, turmoil, chaos, uproar, confusion. Something that is very confusion-based, something that is very chaos-based. There is a lot of ho-halla about that particular event is a pandemonium. Hindi would be upadrav kolahal. Kolahal is too much sound, too much noise being made at one particular point, too much confusion out there. Like you find that in a rally, you find that in a protest that people are doing, you find a lot of kolahal. Antonym is calm and peace. Pronunciation is pandemonium. 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 So what is the Wordaholic's way of remembering this word for a longer time? Look at the left hand side of the particular visual that we have provided. It consists of two words, pande and monium. Pande sounds like pande. Imagine chulbul pande on harmonium. The harmonium, the last word is included in this particular word, pandemonium. So imagine chulbul pande playing harmonium. Utter chaos and confusion will prevail. I guess you will agree with that, if because he's not skilled in that particular department, and if he starts playing pandemonium on the road, people will just create chaos and uproar and confusion. So that is how you remember this word for a longer time. Usage is pandemonium broke out, pandemonium continued. Sentence one, the house witnessed pandemonium with opposition members demanding a special debate on the issue. Sentence 2, on hearing the pandemonium, security guards and traffic policemen who were passing by rushed to the spot. The rest of the two sentences, you can pause the video and practice yourself. We'll be moving on to the next word, panegyric. Panegyric is basically a speech of praise, accolade, tribute, compliment. You are giving a compliment to somebody, you're praising somebody. Hindi would be gungan karna, kisi ki prashansha karna, panegyric. And what will be the antonym in that case? It will be censoring something or rebuking something. Something which is opposite of panegyric is censoring something, rebuking something, scolding something, someone is panegyric's opposite. So how do you remember this particular word for a long time, permanently into our memories through the Wordaholic's way? Panegyric is basically, look at the particular word on the left hand side. We have underlined the portions. It looks like the first word is pan and the last word is kind of lyrics. Gyric sounds like lyrics. So when you have composed a lyric, when you have composed a song in the favor of pan, you are actually singing praise for pan, pani lyrics. After eating pan, you sing in praise, compliment, tribute. So I guess this particular hint will help you remember this word for permanently for your life whenever you come across this word for the next time. Research shows that one particular word like panegyric, if you have to remember it multiple number of times, you have to come across this particular word. You have to at least meet this particular word 8 to 10 times before this particular word can get etched into your memory. But through this particular method that we teach at Wordaholics, only one encounter with this word is enough. Through the mnemonic that you have devised, through the underlining method that we have devised, you can remember this word for a lifetime. Now moving on to the usage for this word, full of panegyric, 208-page panegyric. Somebody is praising in 208 pages. Sentence 1, many Indians are singing panegyric on Modi for his brave step, which others attack him, while others attack him for causing inconvenience to all. Sentence 2, showering a panegyric, she said she likes the intensity of actor Pawan Kalyan's eyes. The rest of the two sentences you can read on your own by pausing the video. We'll be moving on to the next word. Paparazzi. Paparazzi is basically a photographer or a set of photographers who pursue stars to take pictures. That is paparazzi for you. You would be hearing this particular word on the Bollywood news or on the page 3 news of Times of India or Hindustan Times or any big newspaper. Hindi would be patrakarna. Patrakarna. Antonym is there's no antonym for this particular word. Pronunciation is paparazzi. Paparat. It's R-A-T. It sounds like rat. Paparazzi. So what is the way, the Wordaholic's way of remembering this word for a longer time? Look at the word on the left hand side, the visual provided. Photographers are around that particular star and you're papa is not razi. Just imagine, papa is not razi. So what will they be doing? You will be hating these people who are following you. You will be hating these photographers who are following you. If papa is not razi with this kind of photographs, it can go viral on social media. It can tarnish your image. So your papa is not razi. So basically, you will be trying to avoid them. So who are you talking about over here? The photographers. And that is how we'll remember this word for a long time. Moving on to the usages, Hollywood paparazzi, stars avoided paparazzi. Sentence 1, celebrities and moreover actors aren't happy with paparazzi, they prefer to stay away from the lensmen. Sentence 2, Pulkit Samrat, who has had just separated from his wife, lost his cool at the sight of the paparazzi. With that, we have come to the end of the presentation for today. The 5 words that were discussed, keep sounding sophisticated and keep scoring more. And as we keep on saying, if you have a friend, a relative or a colleague who would be interested in learning words the way that we do, you can ask them to SMS ADD or to 9546307452 to receive these power words daily for free. Also, you can like, subscribe and hit the bell button to receive all the notifications for the videos that we keep on posting on a regular basis. This particular book, you can download from the link that has been provided. This particular book will help you master fluency of English in just 30 days and impress people in just 30 days. The entire spoken English and the fluency part is being covered in this particular book. This contains the secrets from the best of best authors, language learning ninjas, polyglots, hyper polyglots. It contains in the entire set of knowledge from these particular people. More than 100 people have been researched over a 5-year period, and that is this book is the result of that particular research. I hope you like this book. This is available on Amazon Kindle. The link is provided. If you want to download this book and read it, do read this particular book. It will help you immensely. Thank you so much. It was a pleasure talking to you.